Okay, in this video I'm going to talk about the method section and what it contains. The method section is the second major section of your research paper. It explains how the hypothesis that you came up with in the introduction will be tested and how your data will be collected and analyzed. The method section is important because you need to convince the reader that your study and your results are believable. If people doubt your results, they'll look closely at your method. Also, if someone else does a similar experiment but gets a different result, then looking at your method will help them to figure out why their results are not the same. So we're going to look at an example research paper about apples, and this is basically the question that is being discussed in the paper. How does the color of sliced apple change over time after being dipped in different chemicals? Okay, here are the independent and dependent variables. The independent variable is the chemical used on the apple. That's what we're going to change. And then the dependent variable is the color of the apple. That's what we're going to measure. So what other variables might affect your results? Well, this is an important question to ask when you design the experiment, and when you write your method section, you should try to explain all of these things. Here are some examples. Could be the amount of chemical solution might change the result, the concentration of the solutions, the kind of apple that you used, the size of each apple slice, the time dipped in the chemical solution, and the temperature of the room, maybe. All of these things could possibly affect the results, so they should be explained in the method, how you controlled them and what the values were. Okay, this is how the method is organized. You start by explaining the object of the study. What is it that you're studying? In this case, the apples. Then the treatment for the object. What are you going to do to the object? Chemicals, for example. Then the procedure to collect the data. How are you going to actually get this data? And then the procedure to analyze the data. Now we'll look at these in more detail. Okay, the first one is the object of the study. So you should explain what is it that you are researching. What is the thing that you are studying? In this case, it's the apples. It's not the chemicals. We're researching the effect of the chemicals on the apples. The apples is the object. And be careful, the object of the study does not mean all the things you used in your experiment. It means the thing that you are researching the effect of something else on. Okay? Part two, you're going to explain the treatments that you used. The treatments means explain what you are doing to your object. In this case, we're going to treat the apple slices with different chemicals. This one, we're talking about the chemicals, not the apples. And this is the independent variable. This is what are you going to change between the conditions. Okay, the third part is the procedure to collect the data. And here you need to explain what you measured and how it was measured. In our case, we want to measure the color of the apples as they turn brown. Okay, and this is the dependent variable. You're going to measure how this changes based on the changes in the independent variable. In this case, how did you cut the apples? How did you treat them with the chemicals? And when and how did you measure their color in each condition of the different chemical treatments? Okay, finally, we need to explain how we analyzed the data. Did we use any formulas or software to convert the data? In this case, we could take a picture of the apples and then use a software like ImageJ to convert it to an RGB scale. You should also explain any statistics that you used. Okay, now let's look at the actual research paper. Here it is. It's called, here's the title, Inhibitory Effects of Various Anti-Browning Agents on Apple Slices. And here is the introduction, kind of a short introduction. Here it tells you the main purpose of this study was to find the most effective anti-browning agent for apple slices by comparing the anti-browning activity of commonly known compounds under the same conditions. Okay, and here's the method section. Sometimes it's called the materials and methods, like here. And you'll see that it's divided into smaller sections, five of them. The first one, as we said, explains the topic of the study. So this is explaining the apples. Liberty Apple Cultivar was chosen for this study because it is highly prone to browning. So they also explain the reasons for their choices. Okay? And they explain the other details about the study. For example, They were stored in a cold room. The moisture content of the apples was 83.6%, and so on. The next part explains the anti-browning agents. These are the chemicals that we're using. Five major groups of chemical compounds tested were either certified okay, and then they have here, table one. So the five major groups, they don't want to explain them all perfectly in the paragraphs, because in the sentences, because there's too many of them, you see here. So they just say table one. So we can look here, and we see here are the five groups, and here are the different things. So you can see here, like acetic acid, citric acid, formic acid. Over here is a honey, salt, and so on. Okay, they also explain about the, for example, the concentration of each dipping solution started at 1% and then decreased to lower concentrations. So that's about the treatment. Next section is these two sections are explaining how they collected their data, but it's divided into two parts. The first one is slicing and dipping the apples. Okay, selected apples of uniform size and color are washed by hand and sliced longitudinally into 10 equal pieces using a stainless steel hand slicer. 10 apple slices were treated in 500 milliliters of dipping solution for 3 minutes and drained. The excess liquid was removed on cheesecloth. Samples were kept on the laboratory bench at room temperature for 3 hours. Okay, so that's how we cut up the apples and got them and treated them with the chemicals. Next part, the color measurement. The changes in the flesh color of the treated apple slices were measured by a Hunter colorimeter at 10-minute intervals for 3 hours. And that is how often they measured them, how long they did the measurements, and then they explain more about the math behind it. The results were expressed as a mean value from 3 replications of the 10 measured samples. So they did 10 samples 3 times and then took the average of all 30 of those to get the value. Finally, the last part is how they analyzed the data. They used the statistical analysis using SAS is a software for doing statistics, and they used Duncan's multiple range tests to check for any significant differences. Okay, and just to review, the method section has 4 main topics that you have to cover: the object of the study, the treatment for the object, your different conditions, and then the procedure to collect the data, and then finally the procedure to analyze the data.